checked your homework? Anyone who did the homework? What is your homework? Are you sure? So, anyone? First, what was the homework?
The meaning of X.
Meaning of the S.
X for
directory. Oh, the X. First, the X for the directory. And second?
S.
S.
Big and small.
And?
Small S.
Yeah.
And T.
T.
Wow.
So first, what is the X on a directory? Anyone? If I call you, but if you cannot answer, as I said, you will get the deduction. Anyone? What is the meaning of X on a directory? So what is the meaning of X for the file in terms of access control? X means execution. So for user group or public. Okay? But in case of the directory, what does that mean, the X? What does X, the permission, means on a directory? Anyone? Give the, I will give the extra point. It will be applied to your final grade, which means it's huge. Yes, but if you are not correct, it's okay.
At least I'm courageous.
Yeah.
What I found is the X means access the files in the directory.
Which means you are traverser, the directory, because there's no way to execute the directory itself. Instead, you can search the list, the file, traverser, whether you can traverse the directory or not. So in other words, if you remove the X permission for the directory for group or the public, the other user cannot access that directory. You can protect your directory. Instead of the file by file permission, you can entirely protect your directory. That is the X. Okay, so first one is done. S. What is the name of S permission in our access control list? IWX, IWX, IWX. That's a 777. We have one more. So S. What is the name of S?
Soft link.
Soft link is the link of the file. It will be L. L is the link. Anyone? What does S stand for? S?
What it does or what?
S.
What's the name of S?
Yeah.
Sticky bit is the T.
No, it's not sticky bit.
Yeah,
it's not sticky bit. Anyone? So all of them didn't do homework.
No.
So it's fair to deduct all student points. So, anyone, what? I will give the 1 minute to search your Google. You did. So, already.
Okay.
Yes.
Set get bit.
What bit?
Set get bit.
Set
get bit.
No. Very close. Very close. Anyone? Set UID bit, correct. It's called a set UID bit or set GID bit. U means
user
ID. G means group ID bit. Then next, what's the meaning of that? If I turn on the stick, set UID bit S, what happened? If you answer that one, you answer, right? Are you answer?
Yeah.
You will get the extra point. The meaning of, if I set the S bit, set UI bit, what happened? for the file.
It sets a bit for the thing.
So first,
it runs as a user, like, not depending on the who invoked the program or who invoked the file. Like, the whichever user has the permission, I mean, they'll be able to execute the file.
Very close, but not exactly. Okay.
It sets a bit for the second, but it doesn't set.
Set UID. Okay.
But it doesn't set any execution bit for it.
No, it's far away.
It runs as a user who executed the file.
It allows to share.
I cannot say it correct, but very close. Anyone who can answer the what happened when we turn on the S bit? Very close, but I cannot say it's correct because it's kind of opposite way.
It will give permissions for the users to write or access.
Write on access? It's not related to the write on access. It's regarding to the execution. Hint, it's the execution. If no one is answer.
It enables users to be treated temporarily as root user.
Similar, but not only root user.
I
really sure
have a question.
Little bit far away. Even the normal user can have the S. Stick it, the set UID bit. Okay, so if no more, I will give the extra point again to if your answer is correct. What is the set UID bit?
Okay, there is big S and there is small S.
It doesn't matter.
Okay, it says, from what I found, file not executable.
I know, it's far away.
Really? That's what I found.
When executable.
Yes, your answer is the closest one.
Yeah, when an executable is set UID.
So I have. The set UID bit file I have, it's my file. Then what happened?
You have access to execute.
Oh, definitely, because it's my file.
Not access, it runs as a user who owns the executable file.
As the owner.
As the owner? I'm the owner.
Okay, so the set UID
bit. Not clear.
It also gets the permission of the group.
Permission of the group?
Permission of its owner.
Yes. What?
If you set the user ID bit, it will allow your user to execute with the permissions of the owner of that.
Correct. So, can you get it? So, I'm the file. Okay, it's my file. Then, if I not turn on, it's normal RWX, RWX, which means it's available for public execution. But I have permission to access the very important device, this one. Okay? I have the permission. But if I give the execution permission, so you are able to execute my file. Okay? What happened when she executed my file? Can she access this one? No. Because it's only allowed for me. But when she executed my file, what happened? Foken EXEC. The child of her will be created, child process. It's not mine. Then my code will be copied, instruction code, copied to during the EXEC, copied. Then still it's not my file. She has only the permission to execute my code. Then, but she does not have the permission to access the disk. So she cannot execute correctly. However, if I turn on S, okay, when anybody who has the permission, she can execute my file, executable file. Then even she take over my ownership. That is a set UID. Her UID is set as the owner, as he answered. You understand? That's the opposite of your answer, right? So ownership will be taken over to who the run execute that file. That is usually happen, for example, not usually but very important. So for example, so Anyone who used the Oracle database? So Oracle data or MySQL, any database. So if you start up your the database management system, database is a software, it's a process in terms of operating system. For example, if you run the Oracle, it will create the Oracle process. Okay? It will create the Oracle process. For example, if you are using the MySQL, it will create the MySQL process. Then they are listening the request from the, for example, what kind of application do you use to access the Oracle database? SQL Plus. Or the, in case of MySQL, MySQL client, then connect. What happens when you connect the database? There will be creation of the Oracle for the request. It's a memory allocation. Then this process works for this client request. MySQL is the same thing. So this is the clone of the original Oracle server. Okay? Who is the owner of the, this one? Oracle super user. Okay? Oracle user. This one? Totally different. It's the other user, public. But this public user does not have the permission to access the file, data file, memory, and a lot of important thing, resource. So do I need to give the permission to the public? It will be messed up. Instead, if you turn on the sticky bit, then this public process pretend the ownership of that process. That is a set UIDB. We can temporarily change set user ID into the owner of the file. This is a very, very useful for the, such a service, client-server process. Instead of giving the permission, so I'd like to give the permission to the all of the user to use the, this one, it will be messed up later. Anytime they can access. Instead, if I turn on the set UIDB, only she create the process or the execute the process, temporarily, the UID, that can be used for what? Also hacking. Because you take over the ownership of that. If you can plug in some invalid code or the suspicious code to do something during the EXEC, right? EXEC is nothing but copy of the instruction. Then if you plug in some of the code that you want, access the some critical the device or resource, you can actually hack your system. Okay? So that is the set UIDB. So we are done. But group ID is the same thing. Okay? Group ID is the same thing. The next one, key. I think you get the extra point and you also get the extra point. Let me know after the class. The key. What is the key? It's called a sticky bit. Then, question is, what is a sticky bit? Sticky means stick on. You can stick on. Why is it T? It looks like the sticky bit should be S, but the S is already used for the set UID bit. S, T. The next letter, so it's T is used for the sticky bit, but also there is another meaning.
Text.
Anyone?
Only the owner can rename or delete the file. Only the owner can delete or rename the file.
Yeah, owner can do that always.
It's a permission to set up the file or directory.
Yeah, permission. What kind of permission?
Execution of the file.
If it is set, only the owner of the file or the directory can rename or delete.
That means, yeah, that's correct from the Wikipedia,
yeah.
Right? You need to understand what's the meaning of that. When do you use the sticky bit?
Like no other user will be given, like nobody else can delete the file. Like if I set
yeah,
it,
so when?
File sharing.
File sharing. For example, why don't you read a little bit more? like the temporary space. So temporary space, like the slash TMP, or slash VAR, variable, or var, slash TMP. They are set as the temporary. Temporary used usually what? It's open to the public, like the bulletin board, which means anybody can delete and write and update whatever you want. But it's not, the bulletin board, this is mine. But, so please do not delete this one. Even though this is a public, at that time you can set turn on sticky. It's a stick on always, except the owner. Only owner can take out the flyer. Okay? So it's usually used for temporary space, temporary or file sharing. So that is the reason T. So from the STTB, T, because S is already used, also temporary space, temporary directory, usually used such a T or large, depending on the operating system, used the capital letter T or T. So then there's some other letter, L is a link, and some other, if you understand such a the X, in addition to IWX, there are more S, what T, what L, and so on, so you can the understand the meaning of it. Each directory has the different, such as IWX and the several the character, the special character of the file. Then, last question, I think the who answered, you and so you will get the extra point. Later, let me know. Last question, how can you set up this one? Anyone? Raise your hand.
UMask
is the actually different. It's a default permission. UMask is also the very important. Okay, mask means what? Covering, masking. So your default permission is like the, even though I do not set any permission, it's always a 6-4-4. Why? Because your UMask is set 1-3-3. It's a masking 777. It's a default permission, but it's different. It's a CH mode. Always you can use the CH mode to change it, this one. For IWX, it's 1-2-4. IWX, which means we have available 3 or 5. So we can use such a number to set up the SORT, which I cannot remember, but you can always check the manual, okay? Manual, man page, then you will know. Then, if you know that this one is much more different from the just creating the file, okay? That's the one of the way. Another, the best way to show the bragging your the skill is you can, if you are using VI very, very fluently, then it looks like the professional, really. So instead of notepad or instead of using the graphical user interface, gedit, why don't you use the VI? Then the editing the source file like the PHP file and the script file is kind of bragging. I have experience. Another way is when you create the file, the executable file, or when you create the directory or shared directory, you can set up the sticky bit or the set UI bit, then you don't have to give the specific permission. Instead, the set UI bit, then you are able to execute it, but you will get the temporary permission like that. Okay? Your boss will love you. No? So, this is the homework, checking the homework. Okay? Very useful, really. That is one of the reasons many of the people love to use the Unix and Linux environment to share. You cannot do the similar thing. You can do the, nowadays Microsoft is getting close to the idea of the Linux system, but still, it's a little bit the gap. So this kind of thing is another example of the access control used in the Linux, comparing to the Windows system. Okay. Any question regarding to this? Why don't you test? Okay, that is the best way to understand. Then you are pointed after the class, please come by me, then we'll give the extra point. Okay, so in chapter 12, so Believe it or not, it's almost the last week of the semester. You have one more week to catch up. You have enough time to catch up. So midterm exam will cover probably up to the chapter 13 after the midterm exam. If you want, it can be comprehensive. No? Okay. I don't think that's always a good idea. If you already studied the first half, then it will be easier. Yeah. But anyway, so chapter 7 through the chapter 13, the format will be the same as the last the exam, which means the, we are going to use the Canvas. Then the, like the midterm exam, I will create the question bank, and for the multiple choice as well as the open-ended question. Regarding to the multiple choice, half of them this time from the quiz. So to do that, we will start the today's lecture after the quiz. Because some of the students complained that if I offer the quiz right after class begin, so that's the reason I checked the homework. I have waited. It's a chapter 11. Then that make us easy to avoid any error.
Yeah.
Surprisingly, not many the people knows about the difference between the sticky bit and set UID bit, really. But it's in operating system level used a lot, especially the server program where the temporary space is used a lot. Because of the name, sticky bit starts S, so it looks like the similar as the set UID bit. Set UID bit is much more important. Ten seconds. Okay, let's just start. Truncate is remove all the data except the data structure itself. Correct name, okay? Please select the correct name. Used in the textbook. Some of the students complained the optional lock, but this time they're good. There's no name of optional lock in the textbook. I wonder whether the student outside like the, this kind of the quiz because it's elementary level class, right? The true or false question. So raise the file is the sequence of the word. Some of them are laughing outside. Index, the sequential accessing method, is used from the IBM. The idea is the files are sorted using the indexing structure inside. But the big master index is separate, the indexing structure. It's a very similar as a B+3 actually, if you learn the B+3 database. I think you probably learn in your exercise lab. Windows, the Linux base. It's a PWD. Does it work in the CMD, PWD?
DIR works in CMD.
But the DIR is the list of the file. Only this name. Do not consider the which one is the general concept or whatever, just this name of the this one, as we discussed in the classroom. Because the last time one of the students complained, anyway, this is a graph structure. So, but we learned the name of this as the acyclic graph. If we allow the cycle, then it will be general. Which one is the most important to identify the permission? It's a user ID as we discussed, set user ID. Username is not important when we grant or to check the permission. Enough time.
Thank you.
R4 W2 X1. If granted 1, is you can add up. So then you can finally calculate. Here. There are many students, even we just covered what is a set UIP here. Okay, so next week we have a couple of more quiz, so do not miss the class. Okay, now we are ready to create the file system, which means if I ask you to develop your own file system, which is my favorite classroom project, even though the student really hate such a project, it's a really good experience and project to get used to. What is the data structure? What is the algorithm? Even that require it doesn't require the huge or the fancy nice the programming skill, but at least you are able to convert existing algorithm to the programming. So we have the undergraduate student, but what is the difference between undergraduate and graduate? The college, the bachelor degree, master degree, PhD. Did I mention? I think I mentioned one time. Master, you should master the subject itself. Then you are able to teach it to others. And also you have the ability to do research, starting research. The research means it's not just the developing. So I sometimes really regulate such a situation. Sometimes the student who got the master degree in my program in our school, and after the graduation, getting the job like even the high school, the graduate requirement level job. I know that there is some inflation or something, the H-1B visa issue or something like that. I'm not saying that I'm supporting the current U.S. government, but only one thing, the strict H-1B visa, the policy will be helpful for my student, as I mentioned, because nowadays, most of them are know about how it works, the H-1B visa, except non-profit organization like the university.